riding a Lexmoto Arrow 125. Just gone through the MOT like 3 days ago. Had to do a few bits and pieces to it. It was a bit of a mistake when I bought it. Look at this guy here. Fucking move. It's a woman. Move! Yeah, I had to do a little bit to it. Had to create new rear shocks onto it. There's a stretch through. Yeah, new rear shocks. I had to refill the front forks with oil. Refill the forks. I had to fix the gears and the clutch. The rear brake was sticking. And something else. Oh, the throttle was loose or something. So this casing, I don't know if you can even see with the angle of the video, but this was moving with the accelerator, so I had to fix that. As soon as I fixed that, it went through fine. Look at this guy here. But yeah, rear shocks cost me 30 quid. Second hand, but you know, did the job, and yeah, bike only cost me 400 quid, pretty decent, mileage was only about 5,000, 2012, so for the money, can't really complain. Whoa, you need to go. There we go. Nice bit of sun. So yeah. Yeah, I haven't charged the camera for a while. I've never done one of these videos before. I've recorded them, I've never edited them. So yeah, I just thought I'd film it on a little ride out, because it does tend to bring out the dicks as well. Obviously a lot of them don't know I'm wearing a camera, so they're kind of oblivious to it until they're already doing what they're doing. But yeah, this is really, it wasn't meant to be a bike review, but I suppose that's what it turned into. But yeah. One of those days, it's all still very wet, but because the sun's out now, you do get the arseholes going up my arse, you know, for doing the speed limit. I'm sure we'll see a few in a minute. Yeah, it's just a nice little route to take the bike. If you've ever been to Wrexham, then you probably know this way. It's going towards Mold. Passing through quite early now. I'm going to see if any petrol by the way I've got for a tank. So, yeah. But, weirdly no one up my arse on this road, which is really weird. I'm not really getting. Maybe when we get a little bit further up. This camera really is for my own protection. So if anything does happen, know, if I have an accident, or even if I'm at fault and I go into the back of somebody, make sure I'm not speeding. Even if I'm at fault and I go into the back of somebody, at least, you know, they can see that I wasn't speeding and whatever else. But yeah, it's this little bit that you tend to get people crawling up, because it's not the 50 yet. You can even see the 30 sign there, it's still 30. But I'm guessing people like to warm the jets up as they're coming up here, because they do just bomb it. Right up my arse, here he comes, he's going coming up. Alright, we're 50 here, so we're going 50. This thing will. There's another thing about this bike. It really doesn't go much more than about 50 or 60 unless you really push it. Look at this car. Yeah. It doesn't go much quicker unless it's screaming. And your red line at about 55. You gotta be careful of that. Just with them being cheap Chinese bikes as well, I'm guessing the engines don't take that much punishment. So yeah, try and stick a 50. I'll go a little bit faster. That's full throttle, but it's not doing much. You can hear it climbing. The speed gauge is going lower. Yeah, you know, in terms of like sticking to the road and the handling and whatnot, it's actually alright. It's a lot better than some other cheaper bikes that I've rode. But I've done CBTs. I've ridden some pretty horrible handling bikes, but, you know, considering they're at test centres. But this isn't that bad. Ever since I've got the suspension sorted, it was a good fail on both, so I got the new rear shocks on it. And the new, well, not new, but I refilled the forks. It was a bit like riding a pogo stick. But luckily now I've sorted that, it's not too bad. For a £400 bike. You know, prior to this I had a Lexmoto Aspire. And even that, brand new, that was like 1300 quid brand new. And it got stolen, it was my fault. But yeah, it got stolen before I really had a chance to run it in properly. The mileage on it wasn't that high. So that was a bit of a shame. Yeah, got more bikes. So yeah, that was a bit of a shame. And prior to that, I was riding a Yami YZF R125, which was £4,000 when I got it new. That was 8 years ago. And the engine seized on that again, my fault for not looking after it. I didn't check the oil enough, and the oil ran out. And when your oil runs out, your engine seizes. So yeah, kids, if you're going to get a bike, put oil in it, because you'll regret it, otherwise it'll be a massive waste of money. I think I sold it for like 800 quid, which wasn't bad for a non-runner. For a guy. What a guy, he waited then. But yeah, in terms of like price difference, obviously this bike is a tenth of the price of the Yami. You can pick them up cheaper. Mine was 8 years ago and I got it on finance, so I don't know if that contributed to it being a little bit more expensive, even though it was 0%. Yeah, it was a good bike. I should have looked after it more.